honor to speak in front of groups of people and to feel that there are like people that are interested in my story, you know, that I have a story to share. I'll just start out with my background a little bit, and there's a through line that I want you sort of to pay attention to. And one is a story of, you know, entrepreneurship, being willing to take risks, of pursuing passion, and then also being practical. And in my life, not all three of those things happened at the same time, you know. I went to college. I come from a family of doctors. My parents are doctors, my mom, my dad, my twin sister, my brother, and I'm the only one who chose not to be. So coming from a pretty traditional Asian family and studying hard and going to college, you know, so what do I do, you know? So I graduated in the late 90s, and I went to work for a technology company out in Silicon Valley, and I was bored. I was bored to tears, but I didn't know what else to do. You know, I knew I wanted to go to graduate school, so I stuck around for a few years, and then I went to business school at UCLA and decided to kind of pursue entrepreneurship. But for me, what that was is I wanted to start a small company or find some cool company to join and be a part of. So I was in LA wondering what to do. I was thinking, you know, maybe I'll start a restaurant because, you know, that's the easiest thing to think of. Everybody eats, so I think, you know, it's easy to come up with the restaurant idea. So I had the idea of a place called, you know, Karma Kitchen, right? So it's like Chipotle, but for Indian food, right? Brilliant idea, right? But I knew nothing about starting a restaurant or what was involved. And I kind of knew down the road that I didn't want to, you know, run a restaurant, you know, 3 years or 4 years down the road. It's like, well, what could I still do in the entrepreneurial space? And through that process of just kind of going through, you know, talking to one person, to another person, to another person, to another expert, and what's it like to run operations? What's it like to set up branding? What's it like to raise financing for different restaurants in my network? I came across an alum from my business school who had was working with a very popular yoga teacher in Los Angeles. And I thought, hey, that might be a cool thing to do. I mean, even though I'm Indian, I didn't really practice yoga. I meditated maybe twice in my life, but I linked up with a guy named Brian Kest, power yoga guy in LA, and I did my summer internship with him in business school. So most of my friends were, you know, in New York, you know, or, you know, up here, or even in LA doing banking internships, or consulting, or brand management, or working for Taco Bell. But here I was going to Santa Monica, walking to work, wearing flip-flops and shorts. And sometimes like nice clothes because I thought I should or whatever, but and going to this, you know, yoga, this small tiny room where we were running the yoga, you know, operation auto, and I fell in love with it. You know, I love that startup atmosphere. I love being a part of something that I could really believe in. And we opened up a second studio. I'm not sure if anybody here practices yoga in the room. If you raise your hand. So you know that yoga towel, Yogi Toes. So Susie Nichols, she has a wonderful entrepreneurial story. She started it. We partnered with her just as she was kind of launching. And we did all her financing and distribution. So that was just kind of another, you know, thing that I got to be a part of. So here I was, you know, just out of business school. You know, we opened up our second studio on 2nd Street in Santa Monica. We were doing all the financing and distribution for this towel company. I opened up our second warehouse for the company. We were doing retreats in Mexico and in Hawaii and all over the U.S. But I had to leave after a while because I hit a ceiling. So, you know, what was that for me? What was I going to do after just, you know, I was in a passionate place. I had, you know, kind of grown this business from $500,000 to $2 million, had a success story there, but what next? And that was a bit of, I kind of come from a spiritual place, right? So anybody know what your Saturn return is? No. Okay, so I was 28. It's kind of in your astrological chart when Saturn comes back into your natal chart. So if you don't really pay attention to what's happening, it can cause a lot of upheaval and chaos. But if you kind of go through the fire, then your 30s and thereafter can kind of find your stride. You know? So that was a lot of fire for me, you know, because I was trying to find myself. And I decided I didn't want to work for anybody, but I wanted to kind of pursue these passions that were coming up for me, which was kind of yoga and meditation, pursuing the spiritual path. So here I was, pretty smart, didn't want to work for anyone, wanted to pursue entrepreneurship. So I started my first company at that time. So I created a small company that we made holders for people with life-threatening food allergies. So the idea was to take the fear out of having the allergy by creating a fashionable holder for people to carry around in your purse. So I have a life-threatening peanut allergy. It's become a really popular allergy. So it was, again, my personal connection, fashion, small business, entrepreneurship. So I started it with a partner. It was a small business. It was my kind of first foray, my first corporation. And I ended up selling it to my partner a couple years after we started. But I did that, and then I started writing business plans for people. So I wrote business plans for small businesses throughout the United States. And again, that was a way for me to, you know, become engaged with entrepreneurs and then also, you know, pursue my passion of helping people and also kind of pursuing the spiritual path along the way. Probably the most important thing that I did during that time was work with a shaman for about 3 years. And I became, and that turned into another business that I wanted to start, which was really about bringing transformational work into the business world. And that's where I would say I pursued my passion, but it wasn't very practical, but I still went all the way down that road, which is I created a transformational leadership consultancy, which is about bringing sort of mindfulness practices and energetic practices into the business world. But no one got it. It was so out there, right? I put up a website, it was called Solstice, it's still up. But I still went there. You know, I sent proposals to McKinsey, I sent proposals to different, you know, consultancies all around, but it was too out there. But my point with telling that story, it didn't go anywhere, is that simply, like, I tried, you know? And was it a failure? Not in my mind, but we didn't bring in any revenue. Algae Haven brought in revenue, and I sold it. So then it was like, well, what do I do now? And what's happening now is, I'm a recruiter now, so I work for the creative group, and I place people in marketing and design roles throughout the Bay Area, whether it's, you know, from production artists to user experience people to information architects. And what I think, what I'm able to do now, and sort of how I think things have come full circle for me, is just a combination of business plus intuition plus helping people, and plus creativity, and plus entrepreneurship, because it's very sales-oriented. But I guess what I want you to get from hearing this story is just about, one, you know, trying things out. Everything comes together for a reason. I think where I'm at now is just a collection of all my past experiences. And I think what's going to happen going forward is yet to be determined. But again, it's going to be a summation of what I've already been through. And then just to touch on a couple of the other points that Owen asked us to talk about is, you know, one of, like, if you're pursuing your next position or an internship, I think you have to be a good mentee. So, you know, what is it to be a good mentee? You know, just being really enthusiastic, being teachable, and then having some knowledge of the space you want to go into. Whether it's doing some research beforehand, you know, trying something out, doing a proposal, you know, adding value to a particular situation or person. So I've kind of found that as something that's been really valuable in all my different experiences and all the different places where I've had mentorship. And then the last thing I want to kind of end upon is that, you know, whatever you're choosing to do, whatever kind of fashion business you're trying to start, is to really create value. So I think in 2006, you could do almost anything and make money, right? In 2009, it became a lot harder. So right now, whatever kind of, whether it's a fashion-related idea, if it's a social enterprise, if it's a for-profit business, you really have to create something that people want to pay for. And why would they want to pay for your good or service as opposed to someone else's? So it's creating value. It's being like, you know what, whether it's a brand differentiator, it's a feel-good differentiator, or it's simply just a better product. That's something to really pay attention to, and to make sure that you're thinking about that every, you know, every step of the way in your business model process and product ideation process. But anyways, I'm happy to answer any questions. I hope that was helpful, and thank you.